Hey, old Stud Walker here with the status report. Later on today, the friendliest art critic in the world, Daniel Rolnick, is coming to visit with his wife. And so I thought I'd cook up a chocolate cream pie that we could have for a dessert. And I've been wanting to videotape this for a while, so here we go. First thing, you want to turn on your oven to 350 and get it going. Next, get yourself a glass of ice water. My shortening, I always keep in the refrigerator to keep it cold. So that's kind of important. So I'm gonna make a single crust pie. And I know that's the wrong way to dip it in here, but I'm only making pie crust, so it's not critical. So I got 1 cup plus a half, because I want to make some cinnamon sticks too. So we're just making a single pie crust. I would probably just use 1 cup. The recipe says use 1/3 cup of shortening. I never measure it, I just kind of guess. That looks pretty good. For every cup of flour, you need 1/2 teaspoon of salt. So I got 1 1/2 cups of flour. Oh, there we go. We got peaches helping now. And we'll call that 3/4 teaspoon right there. Well, what am I doing, peaches? All right. Now I got the pastry blender. And you just go to town on that thing. It's a good time to break out your OCD. And really spend a little time getting this mixed up properly. It's a pretty important step. Oh, thanks, Peaches, for helping out. Peaches is, she loves to help out in the kitchen. She likes to eat that shortening. Better stay out of there. So I like to make sure this is cut into really small pieces. That way it'll make a nice flaky crust. Well, what do you think? Is that pretty good shortening? I guess we're done with that. We can put that away. Somebody that's getting into that, right? All right. I don't know if you can see that. Got to cut in there pretty good. All right, the recipe says approximately 2 tablespoons per cup of flour, but I always add more than that. I've got 1 1/2 cups of flour. I usually put 1/4 cup for a cup of, 1/4 cup of water for a cup of flour. So I need 1/4 cup. Maybe another tablespoon. Okay, mix that up. You want to mix it up just enough, but not too much. You don't want it to get all stiff on you. So I like to mix it up as much as possible with the spoon. Watch out there, Peach. Let me mix it up a little better and I'll give you a chunk. And then once I get close, I start mixing it with my hands. They might not want to eat the pie after they see you track it all through the flour, huh, Peaches? She just loves that pie dough. It's one of her favorite things. Maybe we can get her to do the tricks for pie dough. Let's try it. All right, I got some pie dough for you, but you got to do the tricks, okay? Come here. Come here and do the tricks. Come here. What's the first trick? First trick, you got to say hi. Say hi. That's good. Now turn around. That's good. Now hop. Oh, that's good. Now shake hands. Oh, yeah, okay. Now she's happy. All right, back to the pie making. We don't need all this dough. Not so much. Pretty good. I like to squeeze the edges. Make sure they're all coming together. Plenty of flour. You can never have too much flour, I always say. It helps to have a nice rolling pin. I like this professional style. Lots of flour. Pick it up, turn it over, rotate it, so I get a nice circle here. Looking pretty good. A little bit more. Fork, some holes in there. That'll keep it the crust from bubbling up too much, hopefully. Like that. Okay, it would have been nice if I would have grabbed the pie pans first, but I didn't. It up and push it in at the corner. You don't want any tension on there at all. You want it in there nice and relaxed because it's going to want to shrink as it bakes anyway. So I have to get it in there so it's nice and relaxed. Keep the shrinkage down to as little as possible. So that's it. Should look like that. And we'll stick it in the oven for 20 minutes. All right, now we got this leftover dough. And I'll show you a neat little trick we can do with that. My mom taught to me and her mom taught to her. I guess you just call it cinnamon sticks. You just take the leftover pie dough, right, Peaches? Take the leftover pie dough and roll it out with a little butter and cinnamon sugar. That's a pretty good treat. Not too bad. Get our melt a little butter here. Get it rolled out really thin. If it's too thick, it doesn't want to cook quickly. You end up with it being a little bit thick and doughy. You don't want that. Be almost translucent on the counter so you can kind of see through it. Nice and thin. Like that. That's not too bad. I think that'll work. Okay. Right there. Something like that. Cinnamon sugar pre-mixed. Okay, got a little melted butter here. Easy as pie, as they say, huh? And I like to put a generous amount of cinnamon sugar here. On here, starting with the edges. Filling it in. Baking at the YMCA camp or Kyla, used to have to bake up stuff for the dignitaries when they came to visit, and the head guy, he liked these cinnamon sticks so much, he had me make them special, which I always thought it was just a good way to get rid of your excess pie dough, but he thought it, he really enjoyed those. All right. There we go. All right, well, you bake that for about 20 minutes. Well, about halfway through, you want to come and pull that top pie pan off. All right. Okay, I'm back. Now we gotta work on the filling. I got my pie crust in the freezer getting cold. So what we need to do, this is my own chocolate cream pie recipe that I came up with. So it's nothing too complicated. Pouring in 2 cups of milk. I'm gonna make 1.5 times the recipe. So I'm gonna add another cup of milk here. What you wanna do is stick this in the microwave for 10 minutes. Okay. All right, while that's getting hot, you can go ahead and mix up the other part of the filling. I need 2/3 of a cup. Well, actually, I need 1 cup total of sugar, because I'm doing 1.5 times the recipe. Cup of sugar. Recipe says 2.5 tablespoons of cornstarch. So that's approximately about 1/4 cup of cornstarch. I'll do a scant 1/4 cup, I think. That's a little bit less than 1/4 cup. If your filling is too thick, you can always add water or milk to it to thin it down. But if it's not thick enough, well, that's harder to fix. So it's better to get it a little thick. All right. Then you need 1/4 teaspoon of salt. So I'll just make a rounding. That. I like to mix up my cornstarch and sugar before I add the eggs. That way it doesn't clump up. Up. The recipe calls for 2 eggs, but I'm doing 1.5 times the recipe, so I need 3. That up really good. About halfway through, at about 5 minutes, I like to take the milk out and give it a good stir. And at that time, I usually add a little bit of the warm milk into this mixture to kind of thin it down a little bit. And it heats it up a little bit too. So, I just want to mix it, give it a good mix. It has a tendency to not want to stay mixed, so you need to mix it back up before you add it to the milk. The cornstarch has a tendency to get accumulated at the bottom there. All right, now we just gotta wait for the milk. Well, it's been about 5 minutes, so I'm stirring up my milk here. You have to be a little bit careful when this milk gets hot, because for some reason, if it's close to boiling and you start stirring it, it'll boil over. All right, so I got that heated up. I'm just gonna add just a little bit of hot milk into here. just to thin that down just a little bit. Heat it up a little bit too. All right, I'm going to put this back in the oven.
The microwave.
Okay, I got my hot milk here. Mine actually started boiling at about 8 minutes. So let's see if it'll bubble up when I stick this in. Well, it's not quite hot enough. But it was boiling earlier, so give this a good stir before you add it in there. Watch out, peaches, it's hot. Get that all mixed in there nice. And what we'll do, I'll set the timer for about 3 minutes, and I'll check it every 30 seconds and give it a good stir. It'll start thickening up first around the edges. If you don't get the milk to quite to boiling, it's not critical, but it'll take you longer on this stage I'm doing right now, where you got to check it every 30 seconds. Okay, let's take a look at these cinnamon sticks. Here's how they look. Sometimes I get them a little bit darker. But I'll tell you what, nice and bubbly. Look at that. They are delicious, let me tell you. And here I got some other little cream puff shells that I'm going to fill with some of the filling.
A little longer than 30 seconds there, but
I think we'll live. You probably can't see it, but it's thickened up quite a bit. This you just kind of have to gain a little experience. It's nothing too complicated, but you want it to be pretty thick so it's completely cooked. So I give it a good stir here and put it in for another 30 seconds. I think it'll be good after that. In the meantime, I got my vanilla and butter. And I got 2 ounces of chocolate. Make sure that you use the real butter and real vanilla. It's pretty important. And I think it is, at least. Oh, it looks good. It looks nice and thick. Oh yeah, that looks good. And what I'm gonna do is add my butter and vanilla. Then I'll take a little bit of this filling out. So I'll just have some plain vanilla filling. The recipe says 1/4 cup of butter, so I got a little more than 1/4 cup. Probably about 1/3 cup, I guess. And it says 1 teaspoon of vanilla. I need about 1.5 teaspoons. You know, you can, especially if you're using chocolate or, well, any, whatever kind of filling you're making, you can experiment around with different liqueurs. Frangelica is a good one. Any kind of liqueurs you like to use are really good in cream pie filling. The butter tends to loosen it up a little bit, so if it looks a little bit thick, you'll probably be all right. You don't want it too thick, and you don't want it too thin, so it's just it might take a little experience to figure out what you like best. I'm getting pretty close there. Make sure the butter's all melted in there. I'm going to pour some off into a bowl. That's plenty. Doesn't hurt to taste it. I tell you what, hot custard is delicious. All right, take a piece of plastic wrap and put it right down on top of the filling so it doesn't form a skin. And then stick it in the refrigerator or freezer. Now we can add the chocolate in. So best to break it up as small as possible. And again, you might play around with the amount of chocolate and sugar according to your own taste. Maybe like more chocolate and less sugar, or more sugar and less chocolate. Whatever, it's all up to you. Yeah, I like this recipe because the way it uses the microwave to heat up the milk. If you're trying to heat milk on the stove, you know, you end up burning it half the time, and when you get done, there's always a big mess in the pan you gotta clean up. So I like heating the milk in the microwave. It's no chance of burning it. Same with melting chocolate. I like to melt chocolate in the microwave. All right, I think that's looking pretty good. A little pie shell here. You can see it. Yeah, it did shrink quite a bit. But all right, let me take this and just pour it right in there. Oh man. I tell you what, if you make this for your guests or whatever, they're gonna be impressed. It's not that hard. Most people probably never even tasted anything quite like this. It is really something special. Just put it in the refrigerator until it cools, and then we'll put whipped cream on top. Okay, I'm back. I'm ready to put the whipped cream on top of the pie. I got my whipped cream all whipped up. If you have a choice when you're buying the whipped cream, try to buy the ultra pasteurized if you can. It's a little more stable. It whips up a little nicer. So I got a big giant pastry bag with a tip. If you don't have a pastry bag, just get a gallon Ziploc and cut a little hole in there toward the end. Start small, and you can always cut bigger, but you can't cut smaller. And you can make some round dots or something if you don't have a pastry bag and a tip. I like it, you know, fairly firm, but you don't want it too dry, otherwise you're pretty getting pretty close to butter. Load this thing up. Oops. Alright. Now, I've had this in the freezer for about an hour or so. It seems pretty cool. I'm going to go ahead and start here. Start on around the edges. Try to cover up the crust if you can. And just work your way toward the middle. I figure one cup of whipping cream per pie, but I like to be a little more generous than that. So I probably got a cup and a half or so of whipping cream here. Just about like that. Pretty good. Then I like to take some of the mini chocolate chips and just sprinkle these on there. The whipping cream, I probably added a quarter cup of sugar, probably a teaspoon of vanilla. I didn't measure, but anyway. There it is. Oh man, that's gonna be good. Well, I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you down the trail.